Hi, this is Larry Jordan. This is an excerpt of a recent power-up webinar called Ask Larry Anything, where I get to answer questions from viewers. For instance, this one. Jamie Kirkpatrick asks, are there any tips for working with color masks inside Final Cut Pro 10, like the Pleasantville effect, in terms of the number of masks that you can create? Could there be too many color masks? And the answer is, actually, it's unlimited. Let me show you. Let's work with this image. Let's say that I want to do something with the red roof. I want to select the red roof. Notice that it's not a square, it's not a rectangle, it's a parallelogram, but there's a slight bend in it because they changed the angle of the roof right here. So it can't easily be described with a shape. Go to the inspector, make sure the clip is selected, and notice in the color section there's a thing called correction 1 and these two icons. This icon allows you to apply a shape, so I could make it a circle, or if I grab this, I could stretch it out into a square or a rectangle. Well, a shape won't actually work here, so I'll highlight the shape mask and delete it. Instead, I'm going to click on this, which is a color mask. It allows me to select a specific color. I'm going to grab my eyedropper tool and just drag across the red roof and select the red roof. Notice that the outside circle goes almost to the edge of the red, but doesn't go past it. You need to keep this so it doesn't select the gray, or you're going to select way too much of your background. So I'm going to just drag this across, and I've now selected the red roof. When I click the right pointing arrow, this takes me to the color board, and we'll do something really obvious. Let's go to saturation. I just click on that icon and pull the saturation of the red roof all the way out. And notice that the red roof has now gone grayscale. Or pull the saturation way up, and now we've really beefed up the red of the roof. So this allows me to change the color of the roof without changing the color of anything else. Well, the cool thing about this shape mask and color mask is that there's no limit to the number of corrections you can have. You can have 10 or 20 of them. Most of the time, you're going to be quite happy with 3 or 4 at the most. Most of the time, I just use one, which color grades the entire image, generally pulling the black level down, pulling the white level down. And the second, which would be a particular portion of the image, maybe adding a vignette or adding a beefing up the color of a piece of fruit in the scene or whatever. But there's no real limit to the number of color corrections you can add. See this plus key right here. When you click the plus key, you can add another correction. For instance, here, let me select a color. And we're going to click on the green grass. So I'll just sort of drag across the green grass here. And now let's go punch that green grass up. So let's pump the saturation of the green. Okay, notice that the green grass goes from no green whatsoever to way too much green. So I can make our green foliage look like it's right after a spring rain or in desperate need of a spring rain just by pulling saturation up and down. But I haven't affected the red roof and I haven't affected the golden grain. I'm just affecting the color green. Here again, go back to the color mask, click the right pointing arrow, beef the red roof up, pull the red roof down to make it look even more weather-beaten than it is. So I've got rich spring green after a rain, a very old barn with a roof that's starting to fall into disrepair, and the golden grain behind it. Much more visually interesting. There's no limit to the number of these corrections. To get rid of a correction, simply highlight the one you want to get rid of and hit the delete key. Highlight, hit the delete key. Highlight, hit the delete key. It's always the big delete key, by the way. It's always the one that's two keys up from the return key, not the small DEL key that's next to the end key, because those keys are programmed differently, and you want to make sure that you're pressing the right key. This was an excerpt of a recent power-up webinar called Ask Larry Anything. For a complete list of all of our online training, please visit our store at larryjordan.biz/store. Oh, by the way, membership is a great value. If you need to stretch your training dollars, a subscription membership to our video training library saves you money. You can access all of our videos for a low monthly price of only $19.99. That's more than 500 movies, dozens of hours of training, all in-depth and up-to-date. Plus, members can attend all of our power-up webinars for free. Our training covers Apple and Adobe software. We update it every week. And for more information, visit larryjordan.biz/subscriptions. Thanks.